Let us talk about total internal reflection. What is total internal reflection? Consider this is a boundary or interface of two medium. One is denser, say water, or any other denser medium. Another is air. When the ray of light is incident from denser medium, it bends away from the normal. ये तो पहले पढ़ी लिया आपने. What will happen if I increase angle of incidence in denser medium? Ray keeps on bending towards the normal, away from the normal. Then you will have one angle of incidence at which angle of refraction becomes 90 degree and refracted ray becomes parallel to an interface. This angle is termed as critical angle. So what is critical angle? If you want to define in a single sentence, then you can, even if you can, if you want, you can write it down. It is an angle in denser, angle of incidence in denser medium at which the angle of refraction in rarer medium becomes 90 degree or the refracted ray becomes parallel to an interface. How to calculate critical angle? This is refraction, so follows completely Snell's law. So Snell's law means water to air refractive index sin I over sin R. For I is equal to C, R becomes 90 degree. So W mu A is equal to sin C. Then you can calculate sin C is equal to 1 over A mu W. Why I have done like this? Because maximum refractive index with respect to air values available hoti hain. So C is equal to sin inverse A mu W. This is formula for critical angle. Now question arises, what will happen if we increase angle of incidence beyond C? So when you increase angle of incidence beyond C, say I becomes greater than C, you will see the ray of light is no more refracting now. Rather, it reflects back in the same medium and follows laws of reflection. This phenomenon is termed as total internal reflection, or in short you can call it as TIR. So what is total internal reflection as a whole? You can define. It is a phenomenon of reflection of light in a denser medium from an interface of rarer and denser medium when angle of incidence becomes greater than the critical angle. Is that clear? Now, what are the conditions to obtain TIR, total internal reflection? What are the conditions? There are two conditions to obtain total internal reflection. Number one, the ray of light must incidence from denser medium, and or you can say the ray of light must travel from denser to rarer medium. Number two, angle of incidence in denser medium must be greater than the critical angle. Critical angle has got fixed value for given pair of medium. When medium pair changes, then value of critical angle will also change. मेरे कहने का मतलब है कि water and glass, इन सब के लिए critical angle अलग अलग होगा. So now let us talk about application of total internal reflection. First application is brilliance of diamond. You must have heard about diamond. Many of you might have seen diamond also. मेरे को नहीं पता, मैंने नहीं देखा. But let me tell you कि diamond is a hard crystal और इसके अंदर कोई भी अपनी brilliance नहीं होती है. So how diamond gives shining effect then? It is true fact is total internal reflection. In fact, diamond has very high refractive index, that is 2.42. When I say high refractive index 2.42, means I am talking about refractive index of the diamond with respect to air, and the critical angle is very small, that is 24.4 degrees. Now, how does it make interesting to understand that diamond has brilliance in it? I can explain to you. This all credit goes to the laborer who are basically working in diamond industries. These laborers cut the faces of the diamond suitably in such a way that the light radiation falling at any one face of the diamond or entering into the diamond through any face suffers with multiple total internal reflection before emerging out. This in fact gives brilliance in a diamond. Otherwise, diamond has no shining effect. That hardly matters. People spend thousands and lakhs of the rupees in purchasing diamonds and making its society symbol or social symbol. Second important application is formation of mirage. This is also very important application. In hot summer days in desert areas, what do I see? That there is a water or presence of water at certain distance apart from our position. This effect you can see even in on charcoal roads in metropolitan cities like Delhi. What happens in hot summer days? The heat radiation reflected by the surface of earth. This is surface of earth. Makes all the layers of the atmosphere which are in contact with the surface of earth hotter. As a result, the air starts moving up. And finally, the layers which are very close and nearer to the surface of earth gets rarefied, while the layers which are above the surface of earth are denser than these layers. Let's take an example. There is in a figure we have a tree. What we have shown, the one ray of light coming from the top of the tree hits to this layer. Angle of incidence I assume I. This ray of light gets refracted. Since it is refracting from denser to rarer medium, so angle of refraction is larger. It hits to another layer. Now this angle will be equal to this. you can understand in a separate way. The ray of light hits here, angle R, so angle R, this it becomes angle of incidence for this layer. This is angle of R for the other layer, first layer. Now this angle, it gets further refracted with a larger angle in the rarer medium. So angle of refraction increases than this. And so in this case, angle of incidence with respect to each layer keeps on increasing. And at a certain layer, where angle of incidence becomes greater than the critical angle, the ray of light, instead to get refracted, it gets reflected back. Any person and child standing here, if his eyes receives these rays coming from here, the child or person sees the image of the top of the tree here. This image appears similar to when tree is very close to the pond. That's why when message is sent to the mind by the eye nerves, person starts feeling there must be a presence of water. The third important application is totally reflecting glass prism. Totally reflecting glass prism. These prisms are also used for turning the image of any object by 90 degree and 180 degree. But the principle of working of these prisms is based on total internal reflection. These are basically right angled triangled base isosceles triangle, isosceles triangle like this. This is 45 degree. This is also 45 degree. Let's make a little bigger diagram. Turning of an image by 90 degree. This is an isosceles right angle triangle base prism. This is 45 degree. This is also 45 degree. Object is kept here. Take one ray of light coming from here, top of this object. It hits at an angle of 45 degree. Critical angle for glass air interface is 42 degree. So it reflects back. When you take another ray coming from here, it again hits to this point at an angle 45 degree. So it also reflects back or suffers with total internal reflection. So point A forms image here A dash, point B forms image here B dash, object is, image is turned by an angle 90 degree. You can also turn the image of an object by 180 degree. How? Place prism like this. I am trying to make a larger diagram so your visibility will be better. This angle is 90 degree. Now object is kept here. Linear object AB, I kept it here. One ray of light coming from here suffers with total internal reflection. Again hits another surface. Suffers with TIR again, because critical angle in this case is also 42 degree. Another ray you can take from the point B. This hits and suffers. Again hits to another surface, suffers and returns. So point A is here, A dash and B forms B dash. In this way, you can turn the ray of light by 180 degrees. This is very important for board examination point of view because questions are asked based on it. Let us talk now one of the very important application of optical total internal reflection, and this is known as optical fiber. Optical fibers are very much in use nowadays. In so many applications these are used. What are optical fibers? Optical fibers are fabricated with high quality glass or quartz. Two materials are used, glass or quartz. Optical fiber is a strand with very small diameter, and the diameter is of the order of 1 micrometer, that is 10 raised to the power minus 6 meter. This strand is coated with a relatively low refractive index material from outside on both the sides. This coating is termed as cladding layer. And the inner part is termed as core. Optical fiber also works on the principle of total internal reflection. Let me make a larger figure for you. This is coating, cladding layer. Once the ray of light enters into optical fiber, it suffers with multiple total internal reflections within the fiber before coming out of the fiber. So the refracted light, finally emitted or finally emerging light, has built up its intensity, and you can use optical fibers in so many ways. In fact, large number of the optical fibers are bundled together to form a little thick pipe termed as light pipe. Where are these optical fibers mainly used? Optical fibers are also used very well nowadays in medical sciences. By using optical fibers, doctors can easily see the inaccessible parts of the human body where there is scarcity of light. You might have heard about endoscopy. Endoscopy is done with the help of optical fibers. Many operations are also being done by using optical fibers, and it is found that these are safer, lesser time taking for the patient, less time for recovering it. Second bigger use of optical fiber is in transmitting audio and video signals. So in transmission and reception of electrical signals, what we actually do, electrical signal cannot travel through this optical fiber, as we know. So first electrical signal is being converted into optical signal, and this optical signal enters into the optical fiber which suffers with multiple total internal reflection emerging out either on other side in form of the optical signal again, which is again being converted into light or electrical signals. So converted into light, sorry, electrical signals. For converting light signal into electrical signal and electrical signal to light signals and light signals to electrical signals, we use a device called transducers. These are being used for converting electrical signal to a light signal and then light signal to an electrical signal. In some developed countries like Japan, we are also using for transmitting internet, and after using optical fibers, the speed of the internet is amazing. Another use of the optical fiber is in telephones lines for transmitting or other transmitting cables. Here I would like to tell you, each optical fiber can carry nearly 2000 telephone messages simultaneously without any much loss of energy and interference or superposition of the signals. So there is no superposition of the signals. Signals travels with lesser loss of energy. So this is a very important application where we are using very well in the various fields of the science and medical science.